Hello people, welcome one and all to Jojo's Learning Club.
Hello guys, welcome back to my channel Jojo's Learning Club. So this is the assessment test video on the section Number and Algebra. So far on all the previous videos we have discussed on various sections on Number and Algebra, right? So now it's time to test your skills. So in this video we'll be discussing the first eight questions, that is the part A on the test assessment on Number and Algebra. And on this section you will have eight questions which you should be able to solve it down within 10 minutes. If you are able to solve all these questions, then you can be very much sure about the topic Number and Algebra. Or else if you find difficulty in any questions, you can follow with me while I'm doing it in the whiteboard. Or if you want to do it, I would highly recommend you to try it yourself. For that, you can pause the video at this point and do it, or also in the description I have listed all these questions. Okay, so you can try to solve it down yourself and check the answers also. It's also listed in the description. Or if you find it difficult, once again I'm saying, you can do it with me while I'm doing it in the whiteboard. Also, a quick reminder is that I have completed a lot of videos on Number and Algebra on different sections, and on each of these sections about the questions which are listed here. So you can also have a look on that. Either you can check on the videos, or also I have made playlist, you can check that playlist too. So that's all for this video, and let's start directly. I wish you guys all the best. Okay, so the first question is, the relationship between the temperature in degrees, that is Fahrenheit, and the temperature in degrees Celsius is given by F is equal to 9 by 5C plus 32. So that's a formula, right? So it's a formula, F is equal to 9 by 5C plus 32. And what it is said, we need to find what is the equivalent of 135 degree Fahrenheit. So we have to find the equivalent to that Celsius of it. So what is this given? 135 is given here, right? I repeat once again, there is no use of calculators. You have to try to solve all these problems without the help of calculators. So it is 135, and it is here 9 by 5C plus 32. So let's do 135 minus 32. Let's take all these constant terms on one side of the equation and all the variables on other side of the equation. So 9 by 5C, right? So what it is, 103 is equal to 9 by 5C. So what it is, 103 into 5, that is 515, is equal to 9C. So C is equal to what? 515 by 9. Okay. 515, 103 into 5 is like 515, that's right. So it is what, again you can cancel it by 3. So what happens here, 15, 7, no, it is not cancelable by 3. So you have to solve it by using divisions. So long division method, you have to apply 9, 6, 9, 5s are 45. You get again here, reminder, 65, 9, 7s are 63. Again, reminder 2. 0.2, that's enough. Also, you will have many options in while discussing multiple choice. It's a better option that try to solve the answer first, only then find the answer from the multiple choice problem. It's a good hint, because in multiple choice questions usually they will be listing all the answers in the mid steps too. So once you got the answer, you should look at the options only after finding your final answer. It's a small tip from my side. Okay, let's check whether 57.2, somewhat nearby range, answer is there. Yeah, you can see that option B is 57.2 degrees Celsius. So we have successfully find the answer. So B is the answer for the first problem. Okay, now let's do the second question. It's a fraction question, right? If you can't find it, if you find it difficult to solve these problems, please check on the topics related to it. This is related to somewhat with simple equations. Okay, please check on if you find it difficult to find these answer. Okay, the first second problem is 1 by 3 plus 1 2 by 3 divided by 2 by 3 minus 1 by 3 is equal to. Okay, we need to solve this. You can see that the operators are plus, division, minus. So which should be done first? You should remember the formula, Boat-Mas rule, bracket of divisions, multiplication, addition and subtraction. So whenever there is a division in the problem, you have to solve down the division first, then only consider multiplication, then addition, then subtraction. Okay, for the time being, before all these, what is the first step? Whenever there is a mixed fraction, then you have to write that in terms of its improper fraction. Then only you can solve the problem. Okay, 1 by 3 is what? 4 by 3. How did we get that? 1 into 3, 3. 3 plus 1? 4. 4 by 3. Here what it would be? 1 into 3 plus 2, 5 by 3. Divided by 2 into 3, 6. 6 plus 2, 8 by 3. Minus 1 by 3. Right? So, now what you can do here? 5 by 3 divided by 8 by 3. What would it be? Actually, it is actually equivalent to 5 by 3 into 3 by 8. Right? So, you can cut that and write together this as minus 1 by 3. I'm writing it together. Plus, what it is? Plus 5 by 8. So, what it is? 3 by 3 plus 5 by 8. That is 1 plus 5 by 8. Or you can also write it as 1 5 by 8. Or also in terms of, this is in terms of mixed fraction. We can also write this in terms of improper fraction. So what it would be? 8 plus 5, 13 by 8. Either this should be there in the answer, or 1 5 by 8 should be there in the question given. Yeah, it's already given and it's our problem number A. So this is the answer for the problem number 2. I hope it's very much clear. Okay, the next question is based on transposition of formula. Transposing I equal to V by R for resistance R as R gives. So you can remember also in science you have learned that this is the Ohm's law. From that you know that you have to transpose the formula in terms of resistance, right? So I is equal to V by R. So V is equal to what? I R. Now you have to write R as the subject. So you have to write the formula in terms of R. So how can you write R is equal to V by I? So this is the answer for the problem number 3. So which is the answer? So option B is the correct answer for the problem number 3. Okay, now the fourth problem. The value of 2 raised to minus 3 by 2 raised to minus 4 minus 1. You have to find the answer. Here you have to check the formula of law of indices. The law of indices, what it is? A raised to m by a raised to n is what? Then you have numbers with the same base and their powers are raised. Then what you can write it as? A raised to m minus n. Similarly, you can write this as what? 2 raised to minus 3 minus 4 minus 1. Minus minus will become 2 raised to minus 3 plus 4 minus 1. That is 2 raised to 1 minus 1. 2 raised to 1 is what? 2. 2 minus 1? 1. So, 1 is the correct answer for the problem number 4. It's easy, right? That's why I said you don't need a calculator to do all these sections. You can easily do it. If you can do all these problems without the help of anyone, then you can say that, you are very much confident in the section number and algebra. Okay, now the section number 5. Let's do it. 2x square minus x minus xy minus x into 2y. You have to simplify these algebraic expression. For that, let's simplify. Let's start with simplifying. 2x square minus x plus xy. Then what here? Minus what it is? Minus 2xy. Yeah. Minus x is what? Plus x square. So you can add and subtract all the like terms. Which are the like terms? When their powers of these coefficients, when the powers of these algebraic expressions are the same, for example, x square and x square, that 2x square plus x square, 3x square. Again, which all terms you get? Minus x, you can write like this itself because there are no other terms. Again, here what it is? Plus xy minus 2xy is what? Minus xy. Either this is the answer. Also, one more answer is possible. You can take this x term which is common outside. So what is left? 3x minus 1 minus 1 minus y. You have to check either this should be in the question or this should be available in the question. So let's see. X square minus 3xy. No, this is not the answer. So x into 3x minus, yeah, we got our answer. So the option B is the correct answer for the problem number 5. I hope it's clear. Okay, now the solution of the simultaneous equation. We have two simultaneous equations. Which are the equations? 3x minus 2y equal to 13 and 2x plus 5y is equal to minus 4. So we need to find x and y. Don't look at the answers first itself, then you will have confusions and there is chances of making mistakes. So I would highly recommend you to check the answers only after you get you find your final answer. Okay, let's solve it down. Either you can use substitution or elimination method. I am using a substitution method because it's worked somewhat easy for me. Okay, so 3x is equal to 13 plus 2y, right? So x is equal to 13 plus 2y by 3. You have to substitute that for 2. 13 plus 2y by 3 plus 5y is equal to minus 4. So what it is? 26 plus 2 into 2, 4y. You have to take this common, like you have to multiply this so that their decimal denominators are on the same side. So 5 into 3, 15y by 3 is equal to minus 4. So what else you have to write here again? 26 plus 19y is equal to minus 12. Okay, simplifying this, what happens? So 19y is equal to minus 38. So y is what? 19 goes 2 times and 38. So y is equal to minus 2. So you got the value of y as minus 2. Now you have to substitute in any of these equations and find the value of x. So where would I do it? 3x plus 4 is equal to 13. So 3x is equal to 9. X is equal to 3 and y is equal to minus 2. So check for the answer in the question. X is equal to minus 2. No. Y is equal to minus 2 and x equal to 3. So you got the answer and the option is B. Okay, I hope it's clear. And the next section is what? 8. 5.5 into 10 raised to 2 into 2 into 10 raised to 3 centimeter in standard form is given as. So how to write in standard form? You have to write only one term to the left of the decimal place is written into 10 raised to power. This is the standard form. This is how you have to write numbers in terms of standard form. So let's multiply this. What it is? 5.5 into 2 is what? 11. Right? Into 10 raised to 5. How to write it in terms of standard form? How to write? You have to write only one number to the left of the decimal place. So you push one number to the right of the decimal place and you increment here power by 1. So 1.1 into 10 raised to 6 is your actual answer in terms of standard form. So which is the formula? Again, the option B, or B comes over many times. So here 1.1 into 10 raised to 6 is the final answer. I hope it's clear. So these are the answers for the test assessment and I hope it was an easy section. Now let's discuss the second part on the test assessment. So let's see you over there. Bye bye. Take care.